32 years ago, Bulgaria embarked on the path of democratic change. After the initial upsurge that led to Bulgaria's accession to the Council of Europe, to NATO and the EU, we were tempted to believe that we left the authoritarian rule behind us forever. However, we have learned the hard way that the transition from a centrally planned to a market economy could be accompanied by deep social upheavals. Our transition has failed to root out impoverishment and has provoked emigration and large-scale corruption. A number of corruption cases remained unpunished, and in combination with the concentration of media ownership and growing public apathy, they set the stage for the rise of a new type of authoritarian rule. Fortunately, the events of the last year asserted that democracy is firmly rooted in our society and the people are ready to defend their civil rights. The civil society energy of the protests in the summer of 2020 led to the rejection of the compromise model of governance and to the emergence of new political parties that won the citizens' trust. This new energy testifies that Bulgarian civil society is vital and powerful enough to counter corruption and authoritarianism. Our institutions proved capable of restricting the use of vote buying and of conducting fair and free elections. At present, we witness an active political debate for the formation of a broad coalition government, and I'm pleased to note that in this debate, a priority is given to the fight against corruption. The specific measures under consideration include strengthening the independence of the judiciary, increasing the accountability of the public prosecutor's office, and the quality of the legislative process. A question remains, however, whether countries can be successful in their struggle for democracy if they stand alone. Since the beginning of our democratic transition, the fundamental values of the European Convention for the Protection of Human Rights provided Bulgaria with a moral guidance, and at the same time, we were able to benefit from financial and technical assistance provided by our partners, the EU and the United States. In more recent times, the Bulgarian citizens were not left alone in their protests against the fictitious democracy. In October 2020, the European Parliament adopted a resolution on the rule of law in Bulgaria and thus supported the citizens' aspiration for justice and democracy. The sanctions imposed by the US government under the Magnitsky Act in early June this year ought to be perceived as a strong support for the democratic reforms in our country. The democratic community in Bulgaria relies deeply on the professionalism of the European Public Prosecutor's Office in investigating the corruption and fraud with EU funds. These manifestations of international solidarity testify to a shared understanding that corruption harms not only the countries that are directly plundered, but also the countries which provide safe harbor for the proceeds of crime. The main lesson of our development as a society upholding the rule of law in the last three decades is that no achievement should be taken for granted. Today, Bulgaria stands firm on its democratic path, and we shall focus our future efforts on the effective prosecution of corruption, on building an accountable administration, on safeguarding media freedom, and on promoting the citizens' trust in institutions. The latter shall be the ultimate indicator of our success.